Hey there, Sharon Horne-Ellstrom here. Welcome to day 25 of our Get Your Goals Annual Challenge. Today we're going to talk about your framework. We spent the last 15 days talking about different possible frameworks for setting goals, achieving goals, things to keep in mind and consider. But today what we're going to do is we're going to go back, and it will depend on you how much you want to go back or not. Maybe you already know what and how you want to deal with goals going forward throughout this challenge. But we want to have our own framework. We are going to actually draw out our own framework today. That's our action item. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and I'm going to look at all the previous frameworks. I kind of want to talk about the SOAP framework today, but I'm going to resist because we'll be talking about it a lot this year. But that's what I use whenever I'm faced with a challenge or a choice or a decision is I automatically now, since I've installed this SOAP framework into my subconscious, my mind goes through it. And I use that process for figuring out what is my best course of action in any situation now. So I ask myself, what is my current story? What is my current goal setting, goal achieving, goal results getting process? What do I currently do? Then I say, well, what do I want it to be? What are my desired outcomes and results? And I look at those. I'm going to go back through, since we just did all these different frameworks, some I've got from the, you know, experience with, a lot of experience with, like SMART goals and OKRs and things. Others, not so much. So I'm going to look back and just remind myself briefly, and I'm talking maximum 5-minute review, what I liked and what I didn't like about each of the different frameworks that I tried. Because just like you, I tried all of them on. I went through a goal, I picked a goal, just maybe a random thing. Some days it was intentional, but for the most part, I just picked different goal areas of my life so I could practice using this particular, the framework we were talking about on that given day. We talked about SMART goals, we talked about BHAGs, we talked about backward goals, OKRs, one word goal setting, Lock and Latham's 5 principles, hard goals, whoop goals, tiered goal framework, golden circles, BSQs, big, small, and quick, OGSMs, objectives, goals, strategies, measures, the goal pyramid. Remember the goal pyramid? And a couple more. Hang on. Turn my page so I can look. Micro goals, which I got a lot out of the micro goals one. And then balanced scorecard. And again, I've done balanced scorecard slot. So I'm going to go through it. I'm going to say, okay, what did I like and what didn't I like? What do I want to make sure from a current versus desired standpoint that I include in my goal framework moving forward because I found value in doing the exercise. And this is how I create my own personal frameworks. I go out, I study a subject, I learn a lot of things about it. I learn from a lot of people. Some people will go out, they'll read one expert, they adopt that expert's stuff, and then they apply that. Then they hear about a different expert and they read their books, they go to their courses, and then they apply that to their life. I don't do it that way. I do it where I go out and I get a ton of resources, a ton of sources of information. I read it all. I consume it all. I study it all for usually a condensed short period of time, like 10 to 30 days. And from that, I glean what is going to work for me and what's not. And then I start with my own framework and I test it. I test it. And that's what we're going to do too. We're going to come up with our own framework today. And then tomorrow, I'm just giving you a heads up. You're going to pick a goal and you're going to run it through your framework, just like you did all the other people's frameworks, right? And we're going to see what works and what doesn't, because it's awesome if our first framework is perfect, but very seldom have I ever studied anything. I did this for a lot. I've done it for a lot of different things through my life and my career, both offline and online. For example, outsourcing. When I was running my Italian food manufacturing business, I wanted to know about outsourcing and I didn't have any knowledge or wisdom in that particular area. I had a vague understanding of it, but I went out and I got 25 books and a couple of courses and things on the topic. And that was really before courses were big. And I studied all I could on outsourcing. And then I took all the information, slept on it for a few days, thought about it, and started to create my own outsourcing framework for my business. What would work for me in the situation that I was in? And I'm doing the same thing as you are with this goals framework. I'm going to go back. I'm going to look at all the different things, what feels right to me, what doesn't. I'm going to think about my past experience from my current goal setting process and say, well, what about this could be tweaked based on the new information that I've gotten over the last 15 days? Then I'm going to map it out. I'm going to actually I started to do this. I started to draw out what do I want my process to be. And I'll tell you, I already thought about it this morning. I'm like, I need to make tweaks and changes to this. So I'll share mine quickly so far. But like I said, I'm going to go back and revisit this, and I'm going to come up probably with a slightly different, if not totally different, framework to use as we move forward in the challenge. So right now it's, I ask myself, what do I want? What are my intended results? Then I envision what that's going to look like for me. And when I envision it, I'm like, is that, I ask questions about it. Is that really what I want? Or do I want more? Do I want to tweak it? If anything were possible, and all that with visioning. Then I think about my skills. What have I got? What do I need? And then what do I just want to have access to for skills? And I say want to or got to need to have access to, because that reminds me that I don't have to do everything myself. Fourth, I consider resources, and I do a resource inventory. Again, what have I got? What have I got experience with in the past? What do I need access to? And then what do I want access to? Because needs and wants are slightly different. And then milestones is my current fifth step. And I set little milestones and objectives along the way to my bigger goals. And I do the chunking down and everything. And how do I want to do that going forward? And then what are my checkpoints going to be? How am I going to know I'm making progress as I do each of the different daily things to ensure that I get the end goal intended result that I want this year? Sixth, I am not very good about this one, which is why I added it, because I think it's important to have rewards for different milestones and checkpoints along the way. You know, I reward myself in my life, but I don't do it on an intentional, consistent basis and say, okay, I'm working for this. When I get this milestone, I get this reward. And then seven, action plans. And this is where I got to thinking about it this morning. I'm like, yeah, we can have action plans, to-do lists, and daily things, but we also have to have an overall strategy that we're using to have objectives and action plans again. So I thought about that too. And then the SOAP framework, you know, what's important for me to include in my plan? What's important for you to include in your framework, your plan? It's really a framework. It's just a process or a plan, right? Of how we're going to do something in our life. So that's our assignment today. Go back, pick and choose the pieces of the different frameworks you like or don't like, or you might have an entirely different framework. I just grabbed 15 and covered them. There are literally thousands, if not tens of thousands, of different frameworks and different processes and different ways people do or don't do goals, right? And if you're in this challenge, saying I'm not going to do goals is probably not an option. All right, if I can help you with this in any way, hit me up, because I'm going to be doing it today just like you are. And then tomorrow, keep in mind, as you create your framework, we're going to test that framework out tomorrow and see how it works. All right. Have an awesome day. I'll, of course, be with you tomorrow.